just might hit the long side of my heart. So take my flat and fix my eye. A tethered mind, free from the light. Now I'll kneel down, wait for now. I'll kneel.
Awards. They still selling dope, that's those Miami boys. Killers everywhere, ain't no place Thank you. Matchup between your Miramichi Timberwolves and the Grand Falls Rapids. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please rise. Kindly remove your caps for the playing and singing of our national anthem with Brooke DePlessis.
Count on pass at Baltimore. All right, good evening. It's a Saturday night. It's Hockey TV from the Miramichi Civic Center as the Miramichi Timberwolves and Grand Falls Rapids meet yet again. Their third meeting of the exhibition season. So we are underway. Timberwolves have a 2-0 record, both victories against Grand Falls. Last weekend, couple of games, 3-2 and 2-1 victories by the Timberwolves. Both teams have got some veterans in the lineup here tonight. Starting in net, Isaac Sparrow for Grand Falls. Kenzie McPhail, the veteran, his first appearance. He scores from the blue line, the wrister. Did it come from the rookie? Mitchell Swain with the shot from the point. Might have been deflected in front. Timberwolves are off to an early start. Timberwolves get on the board in their first shot, 43 seconds in. It comes with the shot from the rookie on the blue line, Mitchell Swain, and Ludwig Dufour, who we've not seen, gets his stick on the redirect and through the pads of goaltender Sparrow, and very quickly, Timberwolves have a 1-0 lead here in the first period on their first shot. Danik Dubé-Plouffe, veteran in the lineup, gets an assist on the play, as does Mitchell Swain. So it's a 1-0 lead, so don't have a lot of background on Ludwig Dufour, but certainly a new face in the lineup for the Timberwolves this season. Dumped in by the Rapids and in deep to Chase. Back there defensively, Felix Landry. We haven't seen him in the first two games. Timberwolves exit and Beck trying to come in over the line. Another veteran in the lineup here tonight. And of course, their leading scorer, Jacob Santerre, in the lineup as he works the boards here. Try to work the boards. Thompson comes back to scoop it up. Feeds back to his defenseman, Yannick Hashi. Hashi back for Thompson. He'll skate it out through center. Can't get any further than the red line. And Beck trying to work his way in. Mason Beck battling along the boards, trying to spin away from defenders, trying to get it for Schofield, and that's broken up, and Thompson will lead the tack out. Dishes it off, and a wrist shot coming, trying to get it through, and he did! And Kenzie McPhail with the first save for the Timberwolves netminder as Cole McWilliams got in with a move to get by the defender and a clear opportunity at McPhail. McPhail played last season here for the Timberwolves. Got off to a great start before getting injured. Really didn't get back into the swing of things as he came back late around Christmas with a broken hand. Up and out by the Timberwolves. They come out through center. Liam Travis, he had a goal the other night in the 2-1 victory here for the Timberwolves last Friday night, I believe. Both teams have been off since then. They play again tomorrow in Grand Falls, afternoon encounter. Up and ahead and through center over the line. Opportunity for Bazile. He'll fire it high and wide. And it lets Schofield get away. William Schofield in alone, holding Deaking. Can't get the shot away. Good defensive play to get back by Matula, who got all the way back to break up that play. As it looked like Schofield had very little left in the tank. And Matula turned it on to catch him. I don't even think he got a shot away. Matula around the boards. Has that picked off. Centered out in front. And they try to tic-tac their way to the front. As Dubé-Plouffe It's able to come off the bench. Wrist shot by Ryan from the blue line. Got through and Sparrow steered it aside. Back into the corner, controlled. Dufour looking for Plouffe. Plouffe working the boards. Plouffe drops it off there for Ryan. Can't get his stick on it. Cycled deep by Santerre. Santerre, Dufour, and Dubé Plouffe. Dubé Plouffe came in that trade from Campbellton late last year and instantly found some chemistry with Jacob Santerre. Here comes Dufour down the wing again. Threw it to the front of the net and trying to swat that by as Dubé Plouffe. And now the net, I believe, off the moorings. And we're going to get a stoppage. Shots 3-2 in favor of the Timberwolves. 3 minutes and 50 seconds into this one. Timberwolves score 43 seconds in on their first shot. Off the stick of newcomer Ludwig Dufour from Laval, Quebec. Fresh troops over the boards for Rob McDonald. Schofield back out there again, caught his wind. Up the wing it comes and out. Noah Bro headbands it ahead and gives it off to Brady Paré. And his shot right on, and McPhail's got that and will hold on. So they'll get four exhibition games in before the regular season starts. All against each other. Timberwolves will be in Grand Falls tomorrow afternoon for a 3:00 meeting. And then they'll all get ready for the regular season, which starts for Grand Falls on Friday and the Timberwolves on Saturday. Grand Falls will be home to Fredericton. Up and in, a bounce one in on McPhail. He'll hold on. 15:38 left to go here in this first period. To the line. Betcock through traffic. Sparrow down. Loose puck still there. Gobbled up by Beck. Mason Beck holding along the boards. Got it all the way back to the line. Swain again through it at the net. It's deflected again. This time over the cage. A little bit more tempo in this. Not that there was good tempo the last time these two teams met on Friday. It was a quick game too. About 2 hours and 5 minutes, which I like. The very few whistles. Centering pass out in front, trying to shovel it by and lifted it high with Mathis Hoot. Fired it up and out of play. So both teams have inserted some scoring in their lineup. The leading scorer for Grand Falls last year, Dominic LeBlanc, had a tremendous debut in the Maritime Hockey League, is in the lineup. Jacob Santerre, the leading scorer for the Timberwolves. And a few more veterans sprinkled into the lineup here for this Saturday night tilt. Off the draw, controlled by the Timberwolves. That's Carter Assel back in his own zone. Swung it around the boards, local boy. Puck gloved down and knocked down. And Assel's from Sunny Corner. .14:35 left to go here in the first. Timberwolves with a 1-0 lead on Ludwig Dufour's deflection of a point shot. That should be an icing call. No ice. They wave it off. Back defensively into his own zone goes James Rogers. That puck turned over right on in front. They score! It got onto the stick of Zachary Duguay, and he's able to nudge it by Sparrow. It's 2-0 Timberwolves.
Top of the goal, 5-38. Duguay from Travis in
5:38, the time of the Timberwolves' second goal. It comes again on a good centering pass, and Duguay able to get his stick on that and direct it in behind Sparrow. Pinkson and Liam Travis gets another point in the preseason. He gets an assist. 5:38, it's 2-0 Miramichi. Kept it at the line, but brought back in again, offside. So a quick start for the Timberwolves. Six shots on net. Two have got by Isaac Sparrow, who comes in. Only allowed one goal in his appearances. Doesn't have any wins or losses attached to those, but 1.96 goals against and a 941 save percentage in the previous two games that he's appeared in. Up and ahead, Dufour trying to slugger his way in as Plourd and Santerre back out there. I see Jacob Santerre with a full shield on. Interesting. Shot from the point is blocked. Babcock can't get it through. Swain tried to punch it deep. Good job by the Rapids to get it up and out. In over the line. Grady fired it high and wide. Gobbled up by Paré, but he gave it away to Santerre, who leads to Plouffe. Dubé Plouffe drops it off. Dufour in with a shot right on into the belly of Sparrow. Right into the crest as he was trying to get a good hard shot away and making sure he got it on net. And Sparrow made it look easy. Played just over 7 minutes here in the first period. Timberwolves with a 2-0 lead. Zachary Duguay and Ludwig Dufour, the goal scorers for Miramichi. Off the draw, chipped up and out by Alsa. Two on one. Opportunity, Bastrash trying to feather it through. It's to the front of the cage. It's getting his skate on. It was Jardine to break it up, but McPhail was going the other way and almost ended up in the cage. Schofield throws it deep. Quickly on it there, Adam Pinkson. Pinkson around, working there with David DeLorme, trying to center it out. Schofield trying to fight off a defender. DeLorme gets it deep. In behind, Pinkson. Trying to get it centered out in front. Defensively back there, Yannick Hashi broke it up, got it up the wing. Rapids come to center. In over the line, Dominic Duchesne threw it at the net. It's fired high and wide. Deflected high and wide, rather, by goaltender McPhail. Trying to split his way in as Jeremy Duhamel trying to split the defense. Back the other way for the Rapids. As Bastrash drops it off there for Bellamy. Bellamy's centering pass knocked away. Mason Beck in the corner trying to win a battle for a loose puck. He comes out of a crowd. Snaps it over here. Onto the stick of Felix Landry. Landry can't get it deep. Now he'll look to move it to the line. He does. Landry going to the net. Dropped off here. Holding. Back to the line. Trenholm's shot is deflected up and out of play. And that'll get us another stoppage. With 11:33 left to go here in the opening period. Jacob French is the backup for Kenzie McPhail. We'll see if McPhail's going to get the whole game or not in his first appearance. Nathan Michaud is on the sheet as the backup to Sparrow. Stood up in the neutral zone, and we're going to see a penalty coming up here. It's going to be a high sticking call, and I think it's going to put Grand Falls on the power play. Two games, Grand Falls have the power plays look good. I don't think they've scored in the two games versus the Timberwolves. Back to the line, Evan Bellamy Drops it for LeBlanc. LeBlanc got it right out in front. McPhail with a save. The rebound is still there. Timberwolves can't clear. They push it to the boards. LeBlanc on it there. Their leading scorer trying to orchestrate a power play here. He works it along the boards there for Yannick Bastarache. Bastarache down low. Too hot to handle there for Hoot. Hoot comes out of the corner with it. Back to the line for Bellamy. Bellamy rink wide for LeBlanc. Still a minute left to go in the power play. LeBlanc to the middle. Drops for Bellamy on his off wing. Working his way in, McPhail. Being harassed at his crease was down and it went wide. LeBlanc back to the top again for Bellamy. Bellamy carries it down the corner. Jardine watching him there. Pinkston's out on the penalty kill. And now good play by Jardine to intercept, and he'll angle it off the boards and get it out to center. Fresh troops over the boards for the Timberwolves. 30 seconds to kill. Dubé Plouffe trying to swat it off the stick. They get it to the line, can't get it out. Into the corner goes Assel for it. So Assel got it to the line, couldn't get it by Matula. Matula back into the corner. Got it there for Duchesne. Duchesne's pass too hot to handle. Cormier couldn't find it. Shot blocked and directed into the corner. On it again is Duchesne. Duchesne in behind. Leaves it there. Trying to get it back to the line was Redding, and Redding's shot was blocked. Their centering pass was blocked, and then getting down was Trenholm and got a shin guard on that. Deflected it up and out of play. So a couple of shots for the Rapids, who have looked like a dangerous power play but can't connect. Here with 9-11 left to go in the first period. So they're 0-for-1 with the man advantage and still trailing 2-0. Off the draw, controlled. Timberwolves trying to work him behind. Dubé Plouffe trying to shake a forechecker. Worked it up the boards. Swatted out to center, but good hard back checking by the Rapids. Brings it in over the line. Thompson can't get it through the defenders. Badcock got his size 12s in the way. Flipped into open ice for Santerre. He's in, and a shot. Sparrow, good save. Off the shoulder into the boards. Santerre looks like he has midseason speed as he comes out of the corner. And another good save by Sparrow. He'll hold on. Shots now 9-6 in favor of the Timberwolves. So as I say, Jacob Santerre led the Timberwolves in scoring last year. A tremendous season. One of the bright lights for the Timberwolves during the season last year, is both these teams failed to make the playoffs, so they got something to improve on here. Badcock from the point, his shot, Sparrow took it off the shoulder. Plouffe in again on the forecheck. He's got Dufour with him. Got Santerre as well. Back to the line for Swain. He's going to snap it at the net, and Sparrow got it out one as Dufour again was looking for a deflection of the Swain shot. And he'll hold on. 11 shots now for the Timberwolves here in this first period. Grand Falls finished last season. 39 games played. Remember, again, we didn't get all the regular season in. Ended up with 14 wins and 30 points. Timberwolves were 6th in the Northern Division. Just 9 wins and 21 points. Both teams have some improvement to do. Bellamy out from behind his own net. He looks like a nice, young, intelligent young defenseman on the blue line for Grand Falls. Dumped it down into the corner. Trying to come out of the corner. Hoot got it all the way back to the line for Bellamy. Bellamy's pass deflected into the neutral zone and shoveled right back in by the Rapids. 7:40 left to go here in a quick-moving first period. Snapped over here very quickly for DeLorme. DeLorme rink wide for Schofield. Schofield bounces one in over the line. No icing call. Good draw weight there. It snapped around the boards. Rapids. Good move by Hoot to get it ahead for Bastarache. Bastarache circles at the line but got forced out of the zone. Off the boards and dumping it in off the bench. Yannick Hashi, he'll go in to follow it in. a defenseman. Now he's back, not back defensively, and stood up in the neutral zone. Was back after he got rid of the pass, and a little high up around the chin as well, but that puck deflected up and out of play. 7:01 left to go in the opening period. So Jacob Santerre led the Timberwolves in scoring last year. In 35 games, he had 52 points, including 24 goals, and was really vying for the leading scorer in the league as well. And so did Dominic LeBlanc, who's in the lineup tonight here with Yannick Bastarache. LeBlanc, as a rookie, 22 goals and 50 points to lead the Rapids. From the side of the cage and from a sharp angle, hit the pipe. Got out of the line. Badcock going to dump it right back in again. One thing I've noticed about Timberwolves in the couple of games here in Miramichi against the Rapids is they've been winning some faceoffs. Shoveled ahead. LeBlanc carried in. That's defused and thrown in wide by Hashi. Far side. Pinkson trying to win a battle. Adam Pinkson's been interesting to watch and has been put out in all situations. Shot from the point, knocked off the stick of Beck. Beck blocked it again. It's up in his rigging. Falls down and trying to dig it out. Benzil gets all the way down the Rapids territory. Matula gives it to his defensive partner, Boris, and Boris up the boards and out. Struggling and over the line. Good play by Assel to move it ahead very quickly. Rookie defenseman. Back the other way and dumped right back in again. And here comes the forecheck. Trenholm back there. Took his eye off it for a second. That's angled back to the line for Boris. Boris across for Matula. Matula's shot is blocked. His puck still there. Good stick work by Trenholm to take his man to the boards. Over the corner. Pare got it all the way back to the line for Matula. Over here for Rogers. Rogers now. James Rogers looking for a lane, can't find it. Matula holding, stick handles by a defender, coming with a shot, he fired it high and wide. Rogers will keep it at the line, pressure here by the Rapids. Timberwolves, one player without a stick. Feathered across and trying to find some room out of the corner. It's Noah Bro, Bro knocked down. And good play by Assel to move it ahead, very neat play to move it ahead by Carter Assel. The Timberwolves finally relieve the zone and get some fresh troops over the boards. Up and ahead, Brody Pare. He needs to peel off for a change. He gets it dumped in. Quickly Swain's there with it. A couple of Miramichi defensemen. Miramichi native defensemen back on the blue line. Jardine and Swain both played high school hockey here in Miramichi. Finally dumped in by Miramichi with 4:20 left to go here in the opening period. They have a 2-0 lead. Shots are 12-6 in favor of Timberwolves. Jardine stands it up at the blue line. Close quarters as they try to dig it out. Who's going to win the battle? And out come the Rapids with the puck. Good back check there. Definitely a penalty. That's going to be a slash. And Timberwolves are going to be shorthanded again as a stick went flying. Ludwig Dufour with an aggressive back check with a hard slash. He's going to come to the box. Second power play of the period for the Rapids. who trail 2-0 here in period number one that has 3.5 minutes left in it. Timberwolves penalty killing in the preseason has been excellent. But again, this Grand Falls power play makes you work. And the Timberwolves have done a good job blocking shots. Looking back to the line here, Evan Bellamy. Bellamy dishes it off. Wrist shot coming and a pad save as Belzil got it through. Off the boards comes LeBlanc. LeBlanc trying to get into the middle of the ice. He is hassled. Then another shot snapped on and a save. McPhail down and can't control a loose puck. It squirts all the way back to the line and will get out. 50 seconds left in the penalty to kill. Here comes LeBlanc again. He'll hold, drag it off his stick. Look at the checking, a fierce checking as they got back hard. Couldn't get the shot away. Trying to work into the slot was Adam Redding. Comes Matula. Jokke Petula going back into his own zone. Being watched there by Pinkson. Pinkson forcing the play deep in Grand Falls territory, killing off valuable seconds. Just 15 to kill on the second power play. 2:10 left to go in this, the first period. Up the wing and standing up there. Forced the play and it got deep. Swain's on it. Hard off the glass and out. The penalty's up. We're back to full and even strength. So a real good penalty kill there that time for the Timberwolves. Didn't allow Grand Falls to set up with 1:50 left in the period. Snapped high and off the glass. Gobbled up by Dufour. Goes rink wide for Santerre. Santerre using his speed, trying to go wide. Johnny Cormier watching him there. Steered him to the corner. Dufour trying to win a battle there. Pare got it back to the line. Assel's going to keep it in and snapped it wide. Loose puck to the front of the cage. Still can't get their stick on it. Finally, Pare comes out of a crowd and is able to move it up the wing. Good job standing up. Cutter Assel played very well here in this first period. And over the line, offside. A little too many moves by Dubé Plouffe at the line. But again, I got to admit, I don't know much about Carter Assel. He's from St. Sunny Corner and has impressed me here in the first period with some composure and standing up forwards at the blue line. We'll see if that's going to earn him a spot in the lineup. Jardine bounces one up through center. It's partial 3-on-2 going rink wide. It hit a pad and trickled wide. Beck in the corner lost the handle. Jardine pinches down, shovels it back in behind. Beck trying to track it down. He and Brandon Boris go after it there. Puck comes loose. There's Felix Landry. Throws it around to the other side. Snapped around and Landry's there again, but it squirts up the boards and that leaves room for Dawson Grady to get out through center and he'll get it dumped in. 20 seconds left to go here in the opening period. Timberwolves long lead pass. Santerre can't get his stick on that, so that'll bring up a faceoff. Deep in Timberwolf territory with 14 seconds left to go in this, the opening frame. Timberwolves got on the board first at 43 seconds, very early on their first shot. And our first look at Ludwig Dufour, who's been a presence on the ice. Then Zachary Duguay gets his first of the preseason as it's snapped up and wide. Good opportunity for the Rapids winning the faceoff and getting a chance in the final seconds here of the first. We're going to have some penalties coming up.
at the buzzer.
Welcome back. We get ready for period number two. Hockey TV, Jerry along with you. Jerry Green along with you on this Saturday night. Grand Falls going to enjoy their third power play of the game as a penalty at the 20-minute mark. For Leon Trenholm for tripping is going to give them their third power play. Timberwolves have yet to get a power play opportunity. Grand Falls 0 for 2 in that first period is a factor in the period. So they get outshot 13-7. Ludwig Dufour at 43 seconds on the deflection of the Swain shot from the blue line. Gives Timberwolves a 1-0 lead on their first shot. And then Zachary Duguay bangs in a rebound. With Dubé Plouffe and Liam Travis getting an assist. Travis has, I think, points in all three exhibition games.
Timberwolves penalty number 27, Liam Trenholm, 2 minutes for tripping, time of the penalty 20 minutes. Trenholm for the trip at 20 minutes.
So to the power play again. To the power play again go the Rapids here to start the second period. Bastarash, rink wide for LeBlanc. He can't handle it cleanly, and Badcock sends it down the ice. Minute and 20 left to go in the power play. It's Bastarash through center. Goes rink wide as Marc-Antoine Bedelzil can't get it deep under control, and it's thrown the length again. Still in the nets is Isaac Sparrow. As he moves it around, and Bastarash will work it over the line. Bastarash delays, trying to set up this power play. Just it off to Bedelzil. Zil being harassed there, can't come cleanly with it. LeBlanc goes rink wide, onto the tape, back here for Bellamy. Bellamy for LeBlanc. Across, Bastarash. Bastarash for Hood. Hood goes in behind, centered it right out in front, got all the way back to the line. Bellamy over for LeBlanc. He fired it high and wide. I don't know if McPhail got a piece of that or not. Timberwolves will get some control, and they'll throw it the length of the ice. 30 seconds left to kill. Mateus Hoot up through the middle and dropped it off. Fresh troops over the boards as Dominic Duchesne snaps it around the end boards. Controlling it far side, Adam Redding. Redding gets it back to the line. He rolls off the stick, and that allows Santerre to snap it ahead for Dubé Plouffe. Plouffe, former Campbellton Tiger, came over in a trade late in the season, got it centered out in front, and the penalties up. We're back to full and even strength. So, again, the Timberwolves doing a great job killing penalties here in the preseason. Grand Falls 0-3 with the man advantage here tonight, and I know last Saturday night for sure, last Friday night, again, opportunities for Grand Falls in the power play, and they failed to score in that 2-1 game. And a penalty coming up here to the Rapids. Johnny Cormier in the box for interference. Referees a little tight here tonight with their calls. So he knocked down Santerre, I believe, in the neutral zone. First chance on the power play for Miramichi with a 2-0 lead. Hard hit in behind. It's a little life into the building. Dubé Plouffe for Santerre. rink wide for Badcock. Badcock at the right point holding, trying to center it across there for Dubé Plouffe. That's broken up and sent the length of the ice. McPhail out to play. Dubé Plouffe cutting into traffic and trying to work wide as he came in over the line. Got tied up there with Dufour. Dufour can't get a handle on that. Badcock cuts up against Stream. Badcock bounces it to the line, having a hard time getting inside the zone for the Timberwolves on this power play that still has 50 seconds left in it. Badcock will dance in over the line. Squeezed out by Bastrash. Room over here for Dubé Plouffe. He works in, holding, shooting, and getting his stick in front of that as Yannick Hashian sent it up and out of play. So both teams have had power play opportunities in the first 3.5 minutes here, and nobody's registered a shot. Shots are still 13-7 in favor of Miramichi. That's the way it ended after period one. Defense doing a good job blocking the lanes in front of their goaltenders. Working down in the corner, Felix Landry got it back to the top for Trenholm. Heads up, shoots, and a trade on. Sparrow makes a save and holds on. Interesting, once we reach the midway point of this one, will we see goaltending changes? It's the first taste of action for Kenzie McPhail. Sparrow's seen a lot of action in the preseason. Face-off again, won by the Timberwolves. Schofield won that back to the line. Trenholm down the corner for Schofield. Looks to the front. Now back to the top again. Trenholm. Schofield. Schofield holding. Can't dish it over here. Now threw it to the front of the net. Great shot on by Johnny to score! Banging in the rebound, Felix Landry. And the Timberwolves have a 3-0 lead. It's a power play marker. So Felix Landry, three new goal scorers for Miramichi here tonight. Haven't seen Felix Landry in the lineup. Shot on, scope, knocked down, and loose puck in front. And it's in the net as the Rapids, as the shot was right into the glove of McPhail. He couldn't handle it cleanly. The Rapids answer right back, make it 3-1. So answering back just 38 seconds later to cut the lead to 3-1. Trenholm working on for the blue line, and that's deflected up and out of play. So 4:35 is the time of the goal off the stick of Dawson Grandy. I got Grady on my list, but it is Grandy. Paré gets an assist, as does Bro. And it's 3-1. To the line. Not out. Schofield. holding the line. Works into open ice with a backhand. It goes wide. Schofield in the corner. Swings it all the way back to the line. Jardine bounces it along the boards. Squirts to the front of the net for Sparrow. Leaves it fair as defenseman Matula. Now controlled. Yoke Matula. Right out in front of his own net. Dished it off and trying to move it ahead is James Rogers. He'll circle back into his own zone. Gave it there for Redding. Redding up the wing for LeBlanc. LeBlanc shot. Fired it wide. Trying to work the glove side on McPhail. And again, the opening goal for the Rapids comes off a shot into McPhail's glove that he couldn't hold. And the scramble ensued. And banging in the loose puck to make it 3-1. Jardine pins his man, Schofield. Can't get the handle on that. Matula kept it in. Swung all the way around the far side. On it there is DeLorme. DeLorme can't move ahead. Got a penalty coming up here. It's going to be to the Rapids on a hit down in the corner on Max Jardine. That's going to be a power play up for the Timberwolves here now. Redding in the box. Santerre trying to work into open ice. They're sitting behind for Beck. Beck. Santerre rink wide onto Plufstick. Back to the top for Badcock. Gives it off for Santerre. His quick snapper is on. And Sparrow has the save and will hold on. Power play number two for the Timberwolves in the hockey game. They scored on their first opportunity. That was off the stick of Felix Landry. Came here in the second period at 3:57. Then quickly, Dawson Grandy answered back at 4:35. It's 3-1 Timberwolves. Still a minute and 25 to work on the power play. Shots are 22-8 in favor of Miramichi. So Timberwolves with 9 shots already here in the period, 9-1. Dumped in and the chase ensues. Yanakashi trying to pin it against the end boards. Plufian comes out of a crowd with it. Feathered it across. Shot coming! And a great shot by Santerre. Great chance there. And Sparrow comes out to make the save off Timberwolves' leading scorer last year, Jacob Santerre, who scored 24 times in his debut in the Maritime Hockey League. 12:23 left to go here in the second period. And Timberwolves already with 10 shots in this period and a 3-1 lead. Max Jardine up on the front line on this power play. Back to the line it comes for Trenholm. Trenholm for Landry. Across. Shot coming. It's fired wide. Great chance there by Jeremy Duhamel. And he fired it wide. It's a two-on-one break. Shorthanded. LeBlanc across. And it rolled off the stick. Bryce Thompson had a great chance there. And I think he looked up and it rolled off the end of his stick. Two-on-one shorthanded. Landry's going to get center. And he's going to dump it in. Latest goal scorer for the Timberwolves in behind. Bodies collapse in behind the cage. Max Jardine in on the forecheck, and the Rapids will find a lane and dump it down the ice with 15 seconds left to go in the power play. Trenholm starting out slowly from behind his net up the wing for Jardine. Jardine, too many moves at the line as the penalty expires. We're back to full and even strength, so Miramichi 1-for-2 with the man advantage. Again, lots of shots here in the period for the Timberwolves, and a great 2-on-1 chance for Grand Falls. Did this even result in a shot? So Vallant put it on the stick of Thompson, but couldn't find the handle on it. Off the boards and to the line and out. Shoveled right back in again. Badcock will go in behind his own net. We played 9 minutes here of the second period. Assel will bounce one into the neutral zone. Gobbled up there by Brandon Boris, and he'll dump it right back in again. Carter Assel on it again. In a crowd, neatly moved it ahead. Rink-wide pass onto the stick and ahead for Liam Travis. Travis trying to cut through traffic, couldn't do so. Takes the body on his man and led out through centers. Brandon Grady, Dawson Grandy, rather, fired it wide. He's the Grand Falls goal scorer. Badcock with control. Up the wing, can't get it moved ahead as Travis had it poked back deep into the zone. David DeLorme still can't get it out. Boris can't get it to the front of the net. Squirts back to the line. Who's going to win the battle there? Perret kept it in momentarily, and that's it. As Pinkson lobs it inside Grand Falls territory, and the Timberwolves will make some changes. We've reached the midway point. Burst of speed in over the line. Noah Bro going to send it out in front. And McPhail was sliding across right out of control. The wide open cage was there momentarily. Up here for Dubé Plouffe. Drops it off for Santerre. They come streaking in with DuFord. Santerre with a hard shot. Sparrow takes it right into the belly. Again, control. Can't get it out in front. Centering pass from Santerre. DuFord trying to win a battle. Coming out of a crowd is the Rapids, and they'll streak to center. Bastrash will lead the attack in. Trying to split the defenses. Hoop, they can't get in. No penalty call as he was harassed there by Swain, the big long range of Mitchell Swain. In fortune, comes right out in front. Get all the way back to the line. Bellamy holds it there. Bellamy dance down the boards, being watched, and poke it deep. Bastrash can't get it centered out in front. Dubé Plouffe, nice move out of the corner. Up and ahead, can't get it onto Santerre's stick. Try to go from skate to stick. 9 minutes left to go here in the second period. Jacob Batula is going to get center. He's going to dump it in. McPhail will stop it there for McSwain, or for Swain, rather. Swain will cycle it around the boards for Santerre. He'll chop it. He'll get it returned and off the boards and down the ice, and that's going to be icing charged against the Timberwolves. With 8:40 left to go here in the second period, Timberwolves have 11 shots on net in the period, just one for Grand Falls, a score 3-1 here in the third. These two teams meet again tomorrow, this time in Grand Falls. It's a 3 o'clock start, and that'll wrap up the preseason for both, getting four games in. Shot from the point, deflected up and out of play. I see both teams in the Northern Division have played four games. Campbellton and Edmonton have played a four-game set. They were in Matan last night for an exhibition tilt. I think they play tonight in Edmonton. Summerside, I see, is going to get five games in for them. Playing a lot of the Nova Scotia teams. I think they play Amherst tomorrow to wrap up their schedule. Snapped around the boards. Zachary Dugay, one of the goal scorers. Gets it loose and up the wing. Opportunity, Liam Travis. Travis trying to win a battle on the boards. It squirts ahead. And out comes Adam Redding. Redding's going to get center and dump it in. McPhail out to play. Tied up in his skates, and now he's down. Defense there to clear the puck. Go up the middle of the ice. Almost got picked off. Timberwolves were able to get it out to center. Under eight to go here in period two. Jardine for Badcock. Badcock's pass. Schofield did get a piece of it. No icing call. In deep, trying to win a battle. Felix Landry. Back there defensively. Boris can't work it up the boards. And a sharp angle shot there quickly to the front of the net. And almost got by the goaltender. Duhamel threw it at the net. Wrist shot from Badcock. Wins wide. Trenholm. Dump it back into the corner. Spinning out his back, trying to jam his way to the front. Sparrow down and block the door. Swings back to the line again. Trenholm's got it again. Back in behind for back, trying to feather it out in front. Give it off to Landry. Landry, Felix Landry, buzzing around in the corner. Landry looking back in and into the corner. Got it there for Duhamel rather. Duhamel trying to get out in front. Traffic in behind the goal. Still trying to dig it out along the boards. Are we going to get a whistle? We might, and we do. A very rare freezing of the puck along the boards gets us a stoppage with 6:43 left to go in the second period. Off the draw, Rapids able to clear, and Bastrashel coming over the line. Bastrash holding, snap, and he just missed on the blocker side, and it rings all the way around the boards and out. The Yannick Bastrash with a snapper that just missed, trying to cut into the 3-1 Miramichi lead. Hoot now, rink wide onto the tape, and over the line for Evan Bellamy. Bellamy goes deep. Bellamy holding, trying to come right on in front. He did with a backhand, and that was blocked in front. Chip to the line and out in traffic. A hard back check. Good work to get it loose, and it does come loose. Shot for Pinkson. It's right on. It's good hard work to fight through the traffic for Liam Travis. Pinkson had a great chance to throw it on net. Sparrow with the save. So we haven't seen any goaltender changes here in this second period. Bastarashian trying to center it. Hits a stick and out. Dufour took an eye off it for a second. He'll go back into his own zone for it. Shots are 25-8 in favor of the Timberwolves here in the second period. 5.5 to go in the second frame. Matula lead the attack in over the line. He drops it off. Cut it into the middle pad. Saved by McPhail as the wrister got through off the stick of Cole McWilliams. Dufour in deep. Can't move it up the boards. Takes the body and knocks his man down. Trenholm comes to help. And now it's moved ahead for Dubé Plou. He and Santerre trying to get away. Hard back check coming. It is Tron for Santerre. Rolled off his stick on the back end. Those two are deadly, a deadly combination indeed that developed late in the season last year for the Timberwolves. And Danek Dubé Plou and Jacob Santerre. Dubé Plou, head man, up and ahead as he got it on his stick. Trying to swing wide. Carries it in behind. Still with it. Can't control and get it centered and goes all the way back to center. Leaves it there for Santerre. Gave it back to Plouffe. Plouffe back to Santerre. Working in with a wrist shot. It's deflected up and off the stick of Rogers and out of play. But you can see how those two players seem to know where each other is as they move the puck through the neutral zone and get into the scoring area. 4:32 left to go in the second. Shots in the period. 12-2 in favor of Miramichi. Face-off controlled by the Rapids, and LeBlanc will come out. He holds as he fires it off a stick and up and out of play as Max Jardine was watching him. Yeah. Off the draw, controlled by the Rapids, swing it to the boards. Badcock and Beck trying to fight through. LeBlanc back to the line. Bellamy knocked down in front by Trenholm. He'll work it ahead. And Beck had it roll off his stick. Back into his own zone. Jeremy Duhamel flipped it up and out with under four to go. $3.31 left to go here in the second period. Timberwolves holding on to a 3-1 lead. Face off deep in Grand Falls territory. Schofield taking the draw against Belzile. Schofield gathers up a loose puck, has a man with him. Schofield holding. Will he shoot? No, he goes through across the crease. He was right in on top of Sparrow and tried to go across the crease to DeLorme. Great chance there for William Schofield to get on the board and elected to pass as he got in close quarters in front of goaltender Sparrow. Good hard chuckle on the boards as laying the lumber DeLorme. Also in there, Zachary Duguay. Duguay's got a goal. Schofield trying to get to the front, being harassed, can't get the shot away. Schofield having third season with the Timberwolves. Still with it, DeLorme. Had it stripped and out come the Rapid and over the line. Belil's got it across for Bastarache. His shot hit the pipe in behind goaltender McPhail and it came loose to the line. Still controlling. Cole McWilliams to the line for Matula's shot. Bounces wide. Jardine can't poke it ahead against Bastarache. Beat him to the puck. Bastarache sharp angle shot and McPhail's got that, but the rebound was there for a second and Max Jardine not backing the fact that Bastarache had an extra whack at the goaltender, but the puck was loose. 2:15 left to go in the second. Two goals in this second period. One off the stick of Felix Landry on the power play at 3:57 from Schofield and Jardine. Then Dawson Grandy, just 38 seconds later, made it 3-1 as he banged in a rebound underneath McPhail. Face-off won by Pinkson. Up the boards for Beck. Beck's able to tip it out to the neutral zone. 2 minutes left to go in period two. A quick-moving hockey game. Here comes a quick player in Dominic LeBlanc, dropped it off for Hoot shot, blocker to the corner. Hoot again, snaps in behind for Bastarache. Bastarache trying to feather it out in front. Loose puck all the way back to the line. Matula can't find a lane. All kinds of bodies in front of goaltender McPhail. Wrist shot coming, McPhail down. Loose puck was in his glove again, came loose. Matula looking, shooting, hit the pipe again, and it dribbles wide. Getting across is Trent Holm. Or did maybe McPhail get across on that rebound again? It's like jingle bells down in the Timberwolves end. 1:20 left to go in the open second period. Bastarache drops it off, gets it back, holding. Circles back. Pressure here for the Rapids trying to cut into the lead in the late stages here of the second period. And a get out in front and he scores. They bang it in. Probably a deflection off somebody in front. It is 3-2. So Mateus Hoot is able to get the goal and pressure came and Timberwolves couldn't get it cleared and they score the minute and six to go. Just 30 seconds left to go in period two and an important goal by the Rapids here in the late stages of the second as they were persistent, that top line of theirs with Bastarache and LeBlanc. Centering pass came right out in front for Santerre. Quick shot and a pad save by Sparrow. A good one there in the final seconds. Puck to the boards and that should do it for period number two. But a late goal by the Rapids to cut into the Miramichi lead that was 3-1, make it 3-2. Came at 106 left to go in the period. Shots on goal in the period. Timberwolves had 14 for a two-period total of 27. The Rapids piled some up late in the period. Just 7, though, for a two-period total of 14. 3-2. Timberwolves lead after 40 minutes from the Miramichi Civic Center on Hockey TV.
Jackson, you're a winner. Addison DePlessy, you picked up a prize as well. And Eleanor, Elena. Okay, Elena, you picked up a pass two to the game on Saturday, the home opener versus the Hamilton Tigers here at the Civic Center. That will be the home opener next Saturday night here at the MCC. Congratulations, Norman Cormier, the winner of the 50-50 tonight. Norman Cormier, winner of the 50-50.
Welcome back to the Miramichi Civic Center. Get ready for period number 3-2. Timberwolves leading in this third exhibition game between these two teams. They meet again tomorrow in Grand Falls at 3 p.m. to wrap up the exhibition schedule. Timberwolves are 2-0 coming into this game, beating Grand Falls twice, but scoring just 5 goals and allowing just 3. So Grand Falls have only scored, the Rapids have only scored 3 goals coming into the action tonight, and they've got a pair. And it's a 3-2 lead for Miramichi. Campbellton's also 2-0 in the preseason. They did play last night, but no result came out of Matan. But in Edmundston tonight, Edmundston is leading Campbellton 5-0 in the second period of play. Ready to go here for period number 3. High check by Dufour, takes his man, and there's going to be a penalty here, as he took Dominic Duchesne into the boards. It looked like a hard body check. They're going to give him a boarding call. And interesting, if you make any noise, I guess, it becomes a penalty. Dufour's going to the box. So it's a boarding call that's going to give Grand Falls their fourth power play and a chance to tie this up here early in the third period. They're 0-3 with the man advantage thus far. It's back to the line. Bellamy's going to keep it in for LeBlanc. Back for Bellamy. Evan Bellamy looking for a lane. Just it for Bastarache. Back to the top for Bellamy. Swings it across for LeBlanc. LeBlanc over here for Bastarache. Back to the top for Bellamy as one-timers high and wide. Going to a loose puck on the far side. Landry's there. Jardine's there as well. Can't get it cleared. Coming in with a shot and get blocked again. Timberwolves doing a good job blocking stuff in front of goaltender Schofield. The puck cleared all the way down the ice. A minute has been killed in this power play thus far. Hutt, one of the goal scorers, the latest goal scorer. He's going to try to shoot from there. He holds on. Number 91. Handling at the line. Looked like it came out. It didn't. Now snapping it to the front of the net. McPhail down as the wrister got through from Patrice LeBlanc all the way out to center. Matula gave it away there. Trying to work in with a step shot right on. Saved by Sparrow. Great job there by Liam Travis to strip Matula and then get a great wrist shot away. But caught Sparrow high on the shoulder. Trenholm, he'll throw it the length and knocked down by Travis. And it's going to be offside, I think, at the line. Just 23 seconds left to kill in the power play. And a great opportunity for the Timberwolves while shorthanded as Liam Travis got in. Interesting. Travis has 2 assists. Doesn't have a goal. He's got another assist here tonight. Interesting, we didn't see Jacob Kane in the lineup here tonight. The two previous games had 2 goals and 2 assists for Miramichi. Just 15 seconds left in the power play. Tula works it ahead there for McWilliams. Williams in over the line. McWilliam trying to center it out in front. Good stick work to deflect it out to center, and that'll do it for another power play. 0-4 is Grand Falls with the man advantage. And 0-4, I think, in the preseason versus the Timberwolves. Fours out of the box and swings it back to defenseman Trenholm. Trenholm's going to get center, and he'll snap it in. He'll go to chase, and now Sparrow's going to stop it in behind. He almost gave it away. He did, and the back gets goal! bounce off the Sparrow pass, and the Positives makes it 4-2. Oh, a giveaway by Sparrow in behind his own net, and Dubé Plouffe makes no mistake. The Positives is home. It's 4-2.
Timberwolves first goal. Come to the city, number 7. Number 10, Derek Dubé Plouffe. Unassisted. Shot of the goal, 241. Plouffe unassisted, 241.
So Plouffe in his first game in the preseason has looked like he's in mid-season form. Good quick hands to separate the defender from the puck on the Sparrow bad pass and kept in by Jardine. He's tripped up and knocked down. No penalty call. And the Rapids trying to bounce it out of the zone. Can't do so. Santerre down low. Trying to get it in front for Dufour. And Sparrow got a hold of that. Dufour had a defender on him and maybe deflected it in on top of Sparrow. But this line looks very good for the Timberwolves in their first appearance in the preseason. Assel will dump it in deep. 31-14, the shots on goal in favor of Miramichi here in the third period. 4-0, and they've got a goal here in the period after killing off a penalty. Danek Dubé Plouffe with his first of the preseason. Trenholm, bounce it in deep, no icing call, as back Bellamy goes for it. Evan Bellamy lays it ahead, get it there, through center, good hard back check, is trying to work his way in as LeBlanc. Body knocked down, and there's going to be a penalty here in traffic. It's going to be a elbowing call and put Miramichi down another man. It's 5 penalties for the Miramichi Timberwolves tonight, as David DeLorme's going to go to the box for the elbow. Play number 5 here for the Rapids in this one. They're 0-4. See what they do with this one. 4-2 the score. Opportunity for Hutt. Hutt into the middle for Bastarash. And that hits bodies in front. Loose puck in front. They bang it in. They're standing on the doorstep of Belil. And he's going to bang in a rebound on the power play to make it 4-2.
Thank you.
Grand Falls cut back into the lead, make it 4-3. They finally get a power play goal, 1-for-5 tonight here with the man advantage. Belzile is able to bang in a rebound right on the doorstep. Assist going to Hoot. He's got a pair of points. Also, Bastarash has a pair of points as well. It's the Timberwolves too many times in the penalty box has cost them here. Finally, in the fifth chance, we got another penalty coming up here. It's going to be a slashing call. Be it it's in the defensive zone, you might think that the guys in green are going to come. Yes, it is. It's a slashing call, and Belzile is going to come to the penalty box. Power play chance of the hockey game for Miramichi. They're 1-for-2. Working on number 3 here in a one goal lead. Shots are 31-15. And it's 4-3. Badcock. He'll carry it in, carrying it deep. Dishes it off to Dufour. Rink wide for Santerre. He's the man you want to have with it. He double clutched and couldn't get the shot away. Took his eye off it. Dufour strips his man of the puck outside the Grand Falls blue line. Now gets it to Santerre. Dufour going to the net. Santerre will set this up. Rink wide for Dubé. Plume for Santerre! Or Dufour, rather. And he fired it high and wide. And again, good setup by Yannick Dubé Plouffe. As he found the winger. The left face-off circle. Right-handed shot. And he delifted it. Up and out of play. Lots of time left in this one. 12:46. Shot from the point from Trenholm is right on. Sparrow remains in there. So he started the game. Usually in the preseason, you might see another switch of the goaltenders. McPhail remains in the cage for the Timberwolves as well. Kinsey McPhail to the point. Landry down low for Schofield. Out of the net comes Sparrow to jump on a loose puck and get another stoppage. Still 45 seconds left to go in the man advantage. These two teams meet again tomorrow, 3 o'clock in Grand Falls. The Rapids open their season at home versus Fredericton on Friday. That's a 7:30 start. And then go to Edmundston on Sunday. Timberwolves have Campbellton here a week from tonight and then go to Fredericton on Sunday for an afternoon tilt. Landry's rink-wide pass knocked down by LeBlanc. Matula. He clears it all the way down the ice. 20 seconds left to kill in the man advantage. Landry, one of the goal scorers, squeezes in along the boards. Can he get it deep? He does. Back to the line for Trenholm. Landry, Trenholm, pressure coming off the boards. Can't get a shot away as Duhamel. Back to the line, Trenholm. Threw it at the net, and Sparrow steered it aside. Duhamel around the board. Schofield trying to catch up with that against Bastarash. Squirts to the line. And the shot dribbled in, and Sparrow again steers it aside. Schofield on it again, but lost the handle, and that'll do it for the power play. We're back to full and even strength. A little quick in over the line. Looked like it was offside. Holding, shooting, and just getting a piece is McPhail. As the snapper coming off the stick of Redding just missed. Ahead, all by himself, in over the line. Liam Travis throws it into open ice for Pinkson. Pinkson's shot is in the glove. one for five, and the latest goal on the power play coming for Grand Falls to cut into the Miramichi lead that was 4-2 early in the period on the giveaway that allowed Dubé Plouffe to score his first of the preseason. Dumped in. Pinkston goes in deep. Shovel it to the front. Loose puck. They bang away, and somehow it stayed out. It squirts to the boards and out and down the ice. 10:40 left to go here in the third. Business is picking up. We got a penalty coming up behind the play. And I think it's going to the Rapids. Timberwolves had the puck. I don't know why the whistle came, but we'll wait and see. So the arm was up. The Timberwolves do touch the puck, and the penalty is Travis Badcock's getting a five-minute match penalty for kicking. Did not see it. Not sure where it happened. But Harrison Oprey, the referee, makes the call, and Timberwolves not only a five-minute major, but they lose one of their best defenders in Travis Badcock. 5 minute power play now here for Grand Falls, trailing by one.
What was the call? Max penalty for
Timberwolves.
Never seen
number eight, Travis.
Max give you a suspension?
Huh?
Max give you an automatic.
5 minute match penalty for kicking. Time of 9:25. Badcock, 5 minute match penalty for kicking at 9:25.
And the Rapids quickly pay it off. 21 seconds into the power play. They've tied it at four. Time of the goal, 9:46. And it's 4-4. Now 2 for 6 on the power play as Hoot gets his second of the night. And Belzil, who had the third goal at 4:58, assists on this on the power play. And still the power play continues. Shot on, blocked in front. 9:46 the time of the equalizer at 4-4, and still on the power play for another 3:45. Dishes it off. Stop. Shot. Sharp angle shot and a save by McPhail. Gobbled up along the boards. Duchesne got it deep. Swinging off the boards with a shot. McPhail down again. Blocked in front as trying to get it through was Thompson. Back to the line for Matula. Got by him and out to center. 9 minutes left to go here in the third. Still 3:25 on the five-minute major. Matula trying to stick handle his way in. Looks the boards. Watched. Closely there by Carter Assel. Sharp angle shot rings around the boards and all the way down the ice. Ill-advised shot while shorthand, while on a power play. Missing wide and all the way back into your own zone. Burst of speed through the neutral zone. Belzil has a burst. Can't get in over the line. It's poked back out to center. 3 minutes in the five-minute major left. LeBlanc can't get it centered. Hoot's got it now. He'll pump it deep. Bastarache. Cycles it in behind. Trenholm with time and space. Will he get it out? No, it gets to the line. Kept in by Bellamy. Back in along the boards. Trenholm's on it now again. Liam Trenholm against two Rapids. And LeBlanc comes out of a crowd with it. Looking to the front of the net. LeBlanc holds, gives it to Bellamy. Bellamy, no lane, leaves it there for Hood. Put into the slot. Shot coming. It's on by Belzile. Loose puck. McPhail down, and it dribbled just wide. Pressure here by the Rapids trying to get the go-ahead goal. To the front. They score. LeBlanc got the centering pass. Another power play goal. It's 5-4 Grand Falls. Officially 3-for-7 now. Two power play goals here on this 5-minute major have given the Rapids the lead. To the line, Matula keeps it in. Points for Belzile and Hoot here tonight. And LeBlanc gets in on the scoring. Back to the line for Matula. Looking for a lane, it's deflected. Knocked down, batted at the net, and just swatted wide by Redding. Still control, to the line, Matula. Another one snapped at the net, blocked in front by Jardine, being hooked and harassed. Looking for an equalizing call here in the five-minute major. A kicking major to Travis Badcock. Never saw it. And a great opportunity here for Grand Falls. They've capitalized with two power play goals. Back to the line for Matula. A minute left in the five-minute major. Snapped at the net. It's fired wide. Far side for Cormier. Cormier being harassed by Dufour. Matula can't get it deep, and it's finally off a shin and out to center. 45 seconds in the five-minute major. Grand Falls have made them pay in D with two goals to take the lead 5-4. Coming into the game, Grand Falls had three goals in their first two games versus the Timberwolves. Swain will gather and dump it deep. Still 30 seconds to kill as Bellamy goes back in behind his own net. 36-18, 18 shots, 5 goals for Grand Falls. 3 of them now on the power play. They had no power play goals after 2 games and 2 periods, and they explode here. LeBlanc ahead for Belzile. Belzile trying to drop it off. Penalties up, back to full, and even strength. Finally, Timberwolves kill the 5-minute major, but costly indeed. There's 3 straight goals now by the Rapids after Miramichi had taken a 4-2 lead early in the period on Plouffe's, Adoube Plouffe's goal on the giveaway, and how quickly it's changed. It's now 5-4. I got 3-for-7 unofficially on the power play for Grand Falls. Timberwolves 1-for-3. Up and ahead for Landry. He's got one of the goals. Flips it high into the neutral zone. Bouncing puck. Skating onto it. DeLorme. Duhamel in the corner. Puck squirts loose and up through center. And keep your head up as Noah Bro was coming through the neutral zone and couldn't gather the puck. In over the line. Holding his back. Snapped it across. A saucer pass. A little too hot to handle for Schofield. Trying to go rink wide, that was blocked, and they're going to say knocked down with a high stick. And thought Mason Beck should have shot from where he was. With Schofield going to the net. 36-18, so 4 shots here in the period for Grand Falls. They've scored 3 goals, all 3 coming on the power play. Schofield out of the corner, being harassed and knocked down by Matula. Schofield looks like he's hurt as it swung up the boards. Snapshot fired high and wide off the stick of Thompson. Flip to the line and out Thompson. Feed back into his own zone. Matula trying to play that off his skate. He was able to chip it out to center. Up and ahead and over the line. Wrist shot fired high and wide as Patrice LeBlanc threw it at the net. McPhail's glove is... That puck's hit it, not staying in. Here comes Dubé Plouffe. Plouffe trying to squeeze by Matula. Good play by the defender. Around for Thompson. Thompson will lob it out of the zone. 4 minutes left to go in the third. The Rapids with a 5-4 lead. Three unanswered here on three power play goals. Two of them coming on a five-minute major. Trenholm goes deep. On a penalty that nobody saw, I don't think. Except referee Harrison Oprey, I think, is the one who made the call. Back to the line. Shot is blocked to Santerre, looking to get it to the net. Swain now snaps it across for Trenholm. Trenholm's just able to clear it out of the zone. Swain goes back into his own zone for it. Mitchell Swain. Head for Dufour. Goes rink wide for Dubé Plouffe. Plouffe onto the stick of Dufour. Dufour for Santerre. Cut into the middle with a backhand. Good defensive play to cut him off. And looking to the front of the net. And Dubé Plouffe couldn't get it there. Assel's barely able to keep it in. And now it's going to come out of the zone. Offside, a delay offside. Going to send the Timberwolves back into the neutral zone with 3 minutes left to go in the third. We're in for a fantastic finish. 4-2 Timberwolves led early here in the third. But penalty problems have given Grand Falls the opportunity to take the lead. Especially when Grand Falls hadn't had a power play goal in the two previous games and two previous periods. Centering pass comes out for Jimmy. Plouffe, he hit the pipe. Oh, lots of pipe down in that end. Another pipe hit in that far end. It's Grand Falls did it a couple times in the second period. Cut into the net, Bastarash, and a save. As McPhail got his blocker on that. Plouffe again trying to get away. Dubé Plouffe in, snapped and hit the pipe again. Season's greetings. Lots of bells being hit down in that end. And ding, ding, ding. Bastarash trying to turn the corner. Cuts into the middle. Drops it off now for Hoot. Hoot's got a number of points. 2 minutes left to go in the third. Boris throws it in deep. Up the boards for Mason Beck. Beck gets it ahead. Good move through the neutral zone for Duhamel. Duhamel leads it into the corner. Beck's going to gather. We'll keep her eye on the goaltender. Duhamel to the line. Assel handcuffed, but got it back. Cutter Assel in with a shot. Fired it high up off the glass. Landry throws it back in behind. Battling for a loose puck there. Matula a little aggressive. There's going to be a penalty coming up here. Delayed penalty call. Landry looking to the front. They want to get it to the front and get it touched. And finally it is. With a minute and 17 left to go, the Timberwolves are going to get a chance on the power play with 1:17. So Joakim Matula is going to be in the box for the last minute and 17. So again, important defender for the Rapids is going to find himself in the box. The Timberwolves with a chance to tie. They'll keep our eye on the goaltender here. Maybe they go 6-on-4, but it's 6-on-5, or 5-on-4, if you will, here with a minute and 17 left.
Grand Falls penalty number 78, Joakim Matula. Two minutes for the Rock, time of the 1843. The 2 minutes for the Rock, 1843. Last minute to play in the third period. Back to you,
great chance, shorthanded for Grand Falls. And McPhail with the glove save. Still give the Timberwolves a chance with 57 seconds left. Haven't been able to set up the power play. They're 1-for-3 with the man advantage in the game. And a face-off deep in their own zone. Rapids looking for their first victory of the preseason. Santerre's going to carry it in. Snap it around the end boards for Dufour. Dufour. Landry's able to get it deep for Mason Beck. 40 seconds left to go. Landry trying to come out of the corner with it. For Beck. See who's going to win this battle on the boards. 30 seconds left to go. Bellamy held on a little too long. Dufour was able to poke it off his stick. And now it's flipped up and out of play. And into the crowd. And we'll get a face-off deep inside Grand Falls territory. 25 seconds left. But Timberwolves have had difficulty setting up this power play. An aggressive penalty kill by the Rapids. They got 25 more seconds to do it. Goaltender is now pulled. And there's a timeout by Grand Falls.
Grand Falls is called a 30-second timeout.
So a fantastic finish indeed. Just 6 shots in the period for Grand Falls, and they have 4 goals, or 3 goals rather, all on the power play. After Miramichi had taken a 4-2 lead at 2:41 of this third period. Danik Dupuy-Plouffe with the unassisted goal, but then Belzil on the power play at 4:58. And then the 5-minute major that resulted in 2 goals by Hutt and LeBlanc. As I see, Hutt's got a goal and 2 assists. Belzil has... No, Hutt's got 2 goals and 2 assists. He had the goal late in the second period, too. We're underway. The puck's dropped in. 20 seconds to go. Who's going to win the battle along the boards? Trying to kill valuable time. Comes back to the line. Trenholm gets it across. Shot in front. Pad saved by Sparrow. 10 seconds left to go. It's rung around the boards and down the ice. No icing call as Grand Falls is shorthanded. That's going to do it. 5 seconds left to go. It's tipped into the zone. And the Rapids with 3 goals on the power play in the third period have come from behind to win 5-4 here tonight. Shots on goal in the third period. Miramichi had 11 for a 3-period total of 38. Grand Falls had 6 for a 2-period total of 20. But the power play was the weapon in the third period. It's funny because Grand Falls hadn't scored a power play goal in the preseason until the third period, of which it became an important factor. That 5-minute major to Travis Badcock for kicking, and we'll see whether or not there's a suspension that goes with that, resulted in the 2 important goals for Grand Falls to get their first victory of the preseason. They're 1-2. Timberwolves are 2-1. They'll play for the 4th and final time in the preseason tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock in Grand Falls. Rapids open up the regular season on Friday versus Fredericton. Timberwolves next Saturday night are here to Campbellton to open up the regular season. 5-4, your final score. Grand Falls, Rapids over the Miramichi Timberwolves. I'm Jerry Green saying goodnight from the Miramichi Civic Center.